One of the main external differences from our closest relatives, the great apes, is the almost complete absence of hair on the body of humans. Moreover, our distant ancestors were most likely covered with thick, dense fur. Today, we'll tell you why humans became hairless in the process of evolution. We'll discuss the advantages and disadvantages of such an appearance, and also find out the functions of the hair that remains on the human body. In addition, this video will touch on some unofficial versions of the appearance of man on Earth. To be the first to know about the release of new videos on the channel, you should subscribe. Everyone's also greatly encouraged to comment on new videos. And if you like what you see, give it a like. This will help in the development of the channel and allow as many people as possible to see our content. In fact, our fur's not disappeared anywhere in the process of evolution. On average, the human body has as much hair as our closest relatives, chimpanzees. They're just much more modest in size. Of course, statistics for different regions of the planet and representatives of different nations differ. But in general, all people are covered with thin and short hairs almost entirely. Around the 5 to 6 month mark of its development, the human embryo is covered with thin, long hairs. They have a whitish tint and curl into spirals. Closer to the moment of birth, these hairs disappear. They're designed to hold the so-called vernix casosa. This substance protects the skin and helps the baby to be born more easily. It's believed that in the process of its development, man was able to develop one very important quality for survival. This quality is endurance that is incomparable with many species of animals. Lions and leopards were stronger than our ancestors. Antelopes and zebras were faster, but man still became the dominant species on the planet. Even now, hunters from some indigenous tribes of Africa and Australia use a very unusual way of hunting. They can pursue their prey for days, not giving it time to rest and, most importantly, to cool down. The lack of body hair allows humans to release excess heat by sweating more intensely. Animals covered with fur do not have this cooling mechanism. Therefore, during such pursuit, they overheat and die, not so much from fatigue as from heat stroke. Horses, wolves, and some other animals also have similar increased endurance, but they use other methods to maintain it. The human body is covered with a huge number of sweat glands. In the absence of fur, this allows for the removal of excess heat very effectively. Perhaps the emergence of this mechanism was one of the most important factors that influenced the survival of our ancestors. Man is the only modern mammal that constantly walks on two legs. It's believed that this method of movement was mastered by the most primitive primates. This is how they moved along tree branches. Even now, anthropoid apes sometimes stand on two limbs and occasionally use improvised objects. With the help of stones and sticks, they can hunt smaller animals when a purely plant diet's not enough for them. And for the food of ancient people, larger animals were best suited. Most often, these were ungulates, which were distinguished by good speed. Early Australopithecus, who had just begun to develop the African savannas, ate mainly plants or small animals. They didn't have a special need to run often. Therefore, they remained covered with thick fur. It protected them from the scorching sun, thorny plants, and other troubles. But Homo habilis had already learned to make simple stone axes. They allowed them to cut up the carcasses of large ungulates quite effectively. Even if the habilis didn't know how to hunt such animals normally, they could try to drive away other predators from carrion. And to do this, they needed not only to notice the prey, but also to be able to run to it faster than other competitors. At the same time, the safest time of day for such a hunt was the hottest hours. Dangerous predators like large cats prefer to hunt at dusk or even at night. Here, moving on two legs revealed many advantages. Our ancestors could not even know about some of them. But apparently, they subconsciously understood something like this. It turns out that a vertically located body receives less solar radiation. and at midday, this dose is practically minimal. In addition, with this method of movement, the body's cooled more efficiently. In this case, sweat evaporation directly from the skin, and not from the hairs on the body, occurs more effectively. Therefore, individuals with a minimum amount of hair on their bodies turned out to be more successful in hunting and survival. As a result, evolution led to the almost complete disappearance of hair. At that time, our ancestors lived only on the territory of the African continent. Therefore, they were not afraid of freezing without hair on their bodies. The migration to colder regions happened much later. By that time, they had already learned to make high-quality clothing from skins, build houses, and use fire. But to protect against sunburn and ultraviolet radiation, a black pigment began to be produced in the skin. Before this, the skin under the layer of hair in humans was white. You can see this by looking at modern apes or any other furry mammals. All these animals, with rare exceptions, have fairly light skin under the hair. Judging by the results of research, human skin darkened about 1.2 million years ago. The Cro-Magnons who left Africa 40,000 years ago were also dark-skinned. The reverse mutation occurred after settling in cold climate zones. The skin of those people who remained in the equatorial and tropical zones remained black. Opponents of this theory say that other African animals are still covered in fur. Cheetahs, antelopes, and giraffes also have to run a lot across the savanna, like their distant ancestors, but they still haven't decided to get rid of their fur. As already mentioned, many predators are most active at dusk, and herbivores have other ways to cool their bodies. Basically, the brain needs cooling. That's why antelopes have acquired a network of blood vessels in their heads. Their body heats up by 4 to 5 degrees while running, but the brain doesn't feel this overheating. There are also animals in Africa that don't have fur. These are elephants, rhinoceroses, and hippos. All of these creatures are large and have no other way to get rid of excess heat. In addition, there's a version that some of them have ancestors who lived in the water. And hippos still spend a lot of time in rivers and lakes. According to another theory, people themselves contributed to the disappearance of hair during the so-called sexual selection. If you look at newborn chimpanzee babies, it turns out that only their heads are covered with thick, dark hair. The rest of the body seems completely hairless. The fur on it is thin and almost colorless. In other members of the pack, such an appearance causes a desire to care for and protect. Perhaps the females of our distant ancestors, who had less hair on their bodies, caused the same emotions in males. Therefore, they preferred such ladies more often. As a result, each subsequent generation of not only girls, but also boys was less and less covered with hair. However, in men, these signs are expressed a little less. Another theory of hair loss is associated with the emergence of permanent or long-term housing, although it does not contradict the previous version. Unlike the one-time nests of the same chimpanzees, various blood-sucking insects began to actively reproduce in the permanent homes of our ancestors. Fleas, bedbugs, and ticks. It was easier to detect them on a body devoid of vegetation. And it was more difficult for the insects themselves to exist. In terms of sexual selection, the absence of such insects served as an indicator of the health of a potential partner. Another hypothesis has little material evidence, but from a logical point of view, it's quite integral and discussed. This version is called the aquatic monkey theory, or aquatic theory. Its supporters argue that human ancestors could lead an aquatic or semi-aquatic lifestyle. And one of the arguments in favor of this hypothesis is the lack of hair on our body. They only interfere with swimming, and the hair on the head, as now, was needed to protect against the effects of the sun. But otherwise, this theory is quite controversial and has not yet been recognized by the official scientific community. Modern people are also covered with hair to one degree or another. A cap of hair on the head, in addition to protecting the brain from overheating, can also protect the head from various injuries or blows. The presence of eyebrows prevents sweat from flowing into the eyes, and eyelashes serve to protect the eyes from sunlight and dusk. Thick hair in the armpits and groin retains odors. In these places, especially oily sweat is secreted. It's believed that its composition is still important when choosing a potential sexual partner. Different opinions are heard about the mustache, beard, and sideburns. Many researchers recognize these male attributes exclusively as decorations. According to some scientists, a lush head of hair in men can play the same role as the mane of adult baboons. For them, it's an indicator of a certain status. Charles Darwin in his study said that a beard is a sign of attractiveness for women. But in modern primitive tribes, women consider beardless men more attractive. And for men, it's a sign of aggressiveness. In addition, both men and women consider a beard to be a sign of advanced age. Representatives of all modern nations have both particularly hairy and almost hairless representatives. It's quite difficult to say which of them lives more comfortably in society at the moment. But it's certain that without getting rid of the hair on their bodies, people would not have taken their current place in the food pyramid. How this will affect the further development of our species, only time will tell. We thank everyone who watched this video to the very end. If you're interested in other theories of human origin, we recommend checking out the other videos on our channel. They also tell about the evolution of a wide variety of living organisms that inhabit our planet now or that died out many millions of years ago. See you in the next one.